This video illustrates the principle of star drift method, a polar alignment of an equatorial mount. A rough alignment is first performed by pointing the RA axis of the mount towards Polaris. The up and down tilt of the RA axis is called the altitude adjustment, and the left-right adjustment, the azimuth adjustment. And I'm going to illustrate here the azimuth adjustment for the northern hemisphere. This little black line of the skyboard stands for the actual path of a star during the night. We choose a star that is close to the southern meridian and near the celestial equator. It will rise in the southeast and set in the southwest. I drew the black line by pointing my meccano mount straight towards the skyboard and turning the torch around the RA axis. So this is the star going across the sky, and the bright disk of light represent the view I would have with in my telescope. Perfectly aligned, so the star stays centered. I will now turn the mount counterclockwise in azimuth a bit and see how it tracks my artificial star. The dots follow the track my now misaligned mount makes in the sky. Notice that the star appears to rise. Relative to the track the mount makes. So if the star appears to rise, it means we need to turn the mount in azimuth a bit clockwise. If it appears to fall, then we'd have to turn the mount counterclockwise. Hopefully this process will terminate and we have a good alignment. So what about the altitude adjustment? For the altitude adjustment, we pick usually a star in the east. And here I've drawn again a star rising in the east. By just turning the mount in the RA axis. So what would happen if my altitude was a bit lower? Say I was tracking there. Well, the star would appear to rise faster than my mount. So if the star rises, I just have to turn the mount further up. And if it's falling, I have to turn my mount a bit down.